Hi friends, and welcome back to the channel. Today I will explain you what are the stored procedures in SQL, and I will show step by step in this simple tutorial how to create and call stored in procedures in PostgreSQL. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. This topic is considered to be intermediate to advanced level of SQL. But even if you are a beginner in SQL, I would still recommend watching this tutorial because I will go really step by step and guide you how to create stored procedures with a simple example. So, as a general overview, a stored procedure can be defined as a routine, SQL routine, that allows us to bundle different SQL statements together that can be reused whenever required. This helps to do basically two things: to improve the code in terms of maintainability and reusability. And in PostgreSQL, you can simply use the following syntax: create, procedure, and your statement. But let's jump into the pgAdmin 4. If you do not know how to install pgAdmin, or you have troubles of creating or establishing server, I made a video, you can check it out here, where I explained again step by step how to install PostgreSQL and pgAdmin 4. If you have any questions, check it out and write me a comment, so I will answer it. For now, here is my local server that was created in the previous tutorial. And to make things easy, you can see that I already created the procedure before, but it's just to check out that everything works as intended. But so far in this general Postgres database, we don't have any tables, so I already prepared a sequence of SQL queries in different tabs here in pgAdmin, so this tutorial will not take too much time, and then I will leave all of the queries and code in the either in the description box below or in the comments section. So let's create our table. For this example, I want to create a table called invoices. If you know SQL syntax, basically to create a table you can use create table. If you don't know and would like me to explain and then give more basic examples or maybe possible question and answer for interviews, I can do it as well. Just let me know in the comments below. But right now we will create really a small table with only 5 columns. The first one, invoice ID, which is our primary key, customer name, text, which are not new here, total amount of, for the invoice, and when invoice was issued. And then the flag and Boolean operator, whether the invoice is paid or not, with the default value is false. So if I run it in PostgreSQL, you can either execute by running this play button in triangle or running F5. I will just click it here. We see that output create table query returns it successfully in 104 milliseconds, really small query. To check it out, we can either go here. We don't see the table is not visible. I will go and refresh, and now we have our table and see the columns. So it should in principle work. We can go to this table, either click here, view slash edit data, for example, all data. Or, yeah, and we basically see query here and our empty table. We just created empty table. I also wrote this query here, which I can run. It shows empty table. And we want to populate this table with the data, right? So here's an example of the query that I prepared in beforehand already. Syntax for adding data into our table is the following. We insert into table name, and then basically it's invoices table, and then in parentheses we can specify which columns we want to edit, and then give specific values. For the customer name, we will write just a dummy name, Jane Doe, total amount for 234, whatever units, Canadian dollars, euros, and whatever we decide. Invoice date, it works today. today. So we run this. I go back to this table, just simple query to show the data. Nice, we see that there is one entry, the invoice ID, which is sequential. It starts from one and then goes in the increasing fashion. And then customer name, the total amount, everything works as it should, right? Now, what if we need to run this maybe as a trigger when something happens? We want to add these values into a table automatically. Or we want to simply, like, this is a simple example, okay? It's just adding three values, basically. But still, if it is 10 values, then things might get quite challenging. And to basically simplify the code and our database structure, we can create procedures. If you are unfamiliar with an object-oriented programming, OOP, for example, let's say in Python or in C++, there are functions and there are methods. Functions return value, methods do some modifications without returning value. Basically, there is the same analogy goes for SQL stored procedures. Stored procedures are like methods. They can modify database tables. They can insert, delete, they can select and show data. There are also functions which are basically stored procedures that do not modify the data in the tables, but they return value. The syntax is a little bit different, but I want to just make things really simple here and to show you how to create stored procedure. So here is, you can see the simple syntax base of, for example, we use create or replace procedure, procedure name, parentheses and parameters. We define language is procedure language PostgreSQL, I think that's it. And S here, body, and we close this query. So here we will use our body of the actual meat of this method, right? And here I also prepared the same thing, but there is a bit more comments, so you can see how things can be explained in a bit more precise manner in a way. So we define the creation of a new stored in procedure, create or replace. This or replace allows us to rerun this query infinite amount of times and replace it if it already exists. If there is only create and we have create table, create view, create procedure, create and whatever, if you rerun this query with only create statement, you will run into the SQL error that will tell you that the procedure already exists. And here, as I wrote in the comments, here goes procedure parameters. Then PGSQL is the procedural language used in PostgreSQL. There are several languages you can choose. This is, as far as I know, most common. And S, double dollar sign, marks the beginning of the procedure's body. And then you can also add begin and end if you have a big query here. And in our example, remember, we want to update these values customer name, total amount, and invoice date in this invoices table. So when I go here and add these values, what do we have here? So I already updated the procedure name, which is create invoice. Procedure parameters will be in, it means insert. You know, we will insert these parameters in this, in the invoices table, and we just specify customer name, which is string, textual column, total amount, numeric, invoice data, which is a date. Note that these are local variables. They are not global and only accessible within this procedure. So you could simply name it as X, Y, Z. And then here, values will be X, Y, and Z. A similar thing to object-oriented programming. Then again, our procedural language, and then as the body, we just delete this query as it is, and we just run this, execute, and see that created procedure query returned to successfully in 60 milliseconds. And then when you go here, you will see maybe you will need to update it, and then you'll see that you have procedures here. Then this is just a little query to list procedures in this schema. You might see online that you can use df to show available procedures in your schema. For me, this didn't work in pgAdmin. Maybe in command line interface, a terminal, it will work. But here, this code selects, if we just select all the data here, we'll see that there are a lot of this specific name of this routine, name, routine type, procedure, a lot of things, a lot of stuff. We'll not talk about it. We just see in two ways that the procedure exists here in this Explorer window, as well as you can see it here. And then how to call. To call a procedure, you simply use SQL statement call, right? Call, and then procedure name, and input parameters in the same sequence as they are defined there. So for example, another dummy name, John Q, public, quantity 102, and date, the same date. Let's run this. And then if we go here into our data, we see that we have our two data points, right? Data entities, as it's called, invoice entities. Now I have a challenge, a homework for you. You need to create a stored in procedure to update the isPaid column. You need to convert this false into the true Boolean value based on whatever you think is relevant. But the easiest way is to use invoice ID as primary key, because it's unique and non-null value. It means that it will have unique identifier for every row of this table. So if you can leave your solution in the comments below, or reach out to me to see how I would solve it. And here we complete this simple step-by-step guide for creating and calling stored procedures in PostgreSQL. Smash that like button and subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed it and would like to share a word and help my channel, and stay up to date with the next tutorials. And let me know again if you are interested in seeing something specific. Meanwhile, have a great one! See you in the next video!